We will be discussing the background on the obesity epidemic and the rationale of weight loss surgery. We will outline the different types of weight loss procedures offered at Portsmouth Regional Hospital, and of course, the overall health benefits of undergoing weight loss surgery. Over the last 20 years, the percentage of Americans who are obese has dramatically increased. It is the most chronic health problem and the second leading cause of preventable death. More than 50% of adults are overweight, about a third of both adults and children are obese, and greater than 5% are considered morbidly obese. Obesity is actually a disease in and of itself and causes dysfunction in multiple body organ systems. The good news is that for individuals failing conservative treatment of obesity, surgical treatment is available, extremely effective, and sometimes the only available cure of certain obesity-related medical conditions.
So what are the risks of being obese? Obesity can lead to many dangerous health conditions, including diabetes, asthma, hypertension, arthritis and joint pain, stress incontinence, migraines, depression, and fertility problems. It is anticipated that the next generation will not live as long as the current generation if things continue the way they are. If your weight is more than twice your ideal body weight, your risk of early death is doubled compared to someone who is not obese. Bariatric surgery can change this.
When combined with a comprehensive treatment plan, bariatric surgery can act as an effective tool to provide you with a long-term weight loss and help you increase your quality of health. Bariatric surgery has been shown to help improve or resolve obesity-related conditions such as type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, heart disease, and more. Significant weight loss through bariatric surgery may also pave the way for many other exciting opportunities for you, your family, and most importantly, your health. Now let's discuss how we define obesity. The BMI, or body mass index, is a ratio of weight over height and is a more accurate predictor of the class of obesity than just weight alone. The normal body mass index range is between 19 and 25. An individual is considered overweight if their BMI is up to 29. Class 1 obesity is defined if the BMI is between 30 and 35. Class 2 is between 35 and 40. And class 3, or severe obesity, is when the BMI exceeds 40. You can easily calculate your body mass index with a chart like this. Just find a number where your height and weight intersect. You might be a candidate for weight loss surgery if your current BMI is greater than 40 without any medical conditions, or a BMI of 35 with at least one major comorbidity, like hypertension, diabetes, sleep apnea, or other medical problems. How do these surgeries help you lose weight? Weight loss surgery will help you lose weight in two possible ways, restriction and malabsorption. Restrictive surgery restricts the amount of food that you can comfortably eat so you can take in fewer calories. Malabsorption not only restricts your body's calorie intake, but also limits your body's ability to absorb nutrients and calories.
Bariatric surgery, such as gastric bypass and sleeve gastrectomy, work by changing the anatomy of your gastrointestinal tract and by causing different physiologic changes in your body that change your energy balance and fat metabolism. Regardless of which bariatric surgery procedure we decide is best for you, it is important to remember that bariatric surgery is a tool. Weight loss success depends on many other important factors, such as nutrition, exercise, behavior modification, and more. By changing your gastrointestinal anatomy, certain bariatric procedures affect the production of intestinal hormones in a way that reduces hunger and appetite and increases your feeling of fullness. The end result is a reduction in the desire to eat and in the frequency of eating. Interestingly, these surgically induced changes in hormones are opposite to those produced by dietary weight loss alone.